State budget cuts may cause the release of nearly 900 prisoners. That's one option being considered by state prison officials because of $22 million in cuts. As 16 WAPT's Catherine Kite reports, another option would put some sheriffs in a bind.
More than 160 state inmates live in this joint county and state work facility in Hinds County. The Department of Corrections encouraged counties like Hinds to build them and take on state prisoners. They get $20 per inmate each day, and the inmates do work in the county. Now, because of budget cuts, MDOC is telling 33 counties the paychecks are about to stop March 15th.
We just built that building. And we have, we counted on the revenue from those inmates that would be housed there in order to help service that debt and operate the facility.
It costs about $20 a day to house an inmate at the Joint County State Work Facility. It's about $40 a day to house an inmate at the state penitentiary. But MDOC says because the state penitentiary has empty beds right now, it only makes sense to move these inmates to the state penitentiary and save that money that would be allocated to these facilities. Another option is to release nearly 900 nonviolent offenders. Either a release or inmate takeaway, according to Holmes County Sheriff Willie March, would be devastating. They spent money to build and house these prisoners and count on inmate labor to keep county upkeep costs down.
And I can see this more like a divorce coming down from the sheriff and Department of Correction, because we've been good stewards of the taxpayer money, and now we'll be being punished.
MDOC's hoping the governor will hand over more money to keep inmates at county facilities. Catherine Kite, 16 WAPT News.
Well, some sheriffs say if they lose funding, they may have to rent their buildings to private prison operations to offset the cost.